So, when I get to the shop today, well, when I left the shop yesterday, my Impala was sitting here, and this car was sitting here. So, my dad then rolled his car over here, moved my car over there. Took his car back off the frame. If you can see here, you see it's been off the frame one time. Here's the frame right here, sitting outside the shop. It's the old frame. So I asked him, man, what's going on? Well, while working and prepping the inside floor for paint, he found this spot here. And he said the only way to fix it was to take the car back off the frame, cut this piece out, weld up the floor, and weld that piece back in. You can see he already started cutting out some of the bracing on this side and this side. The bracing is sitting over here. He got a label passenger side, driver side. Guys, it's a lot of work going to getting the car right. You may say, why would he do all that work and still put that rusty frame back under the car? Well, it's the original frame that was under the car. If you can see the front, he actually started sandblasting it to get it ready for paint. But while under the car, he saw it had a little rust. You see that rust right there? So, we went to the junkyard, and we got another frame. That frame, the new frame, he sandblasted it, painted it, got it ready. It's sitting here. The frame is painted up and ready to go. Got his new control arms on it. Got his new steering box on it. New motor mounts. New disc brakes. New brake lines. New rear end. Everything's new, y'all. New sway bar. New rear end cover. New shocks. New disc brakes on the back. So this frame is going under this car. And guess what, y'all? Got a motor for it too. Don't tell him I showed you. It's an all aluminum 427, ready to go. So when people come to the shop, they ask my dad, hey, when you going racing again? Well, here's his race car. He's up in the Raptors and may be retired because he's focused on this car now. So guys, I'm going to be documenting this build also, keeping you guys updated on what he has going on. He's already replaced the quarter panels on it. You can see here on both sides. So it should be a pretty neat car. Oh, he also put new inner fender wells in it. Guys, how many builds have you seen where the builder replaced the inner fender wells? He's going all the way with it. You see? You can see right here where he welded the new fender well to the old. He replaced all this. It's a lot of work has been done. But it's also a lot of work to be done. So guys, like and subscribe to the page so you can take this journey with us. Because my dad builds his 66 Biscayne. And right now, I'm over here trying to find out what's wrong with my baby. If you look at some of the previous videos, you know, he's still trying to find the smoke.